Hello, welcome to my channel. My name is Nurse Pauline RN. Today we'll be talking about impaired skin integrity. Before we get started, please hit the like button, the subscribe button, share my video please, and comment. The main cause of skin integrity is tissue ischemia. Tissue ischemia is restriction of blood supply to the tissues, causing shortage of oxygen that is needed to keep the tissues alive. Patients at risk for impaired skin integrity: the elderly, diabetic patients, patients who are total care with malignant diseases, patients who are unconscious. We should turn our patients every 2 hours, apply barrier cream to the bony prominences. Do not massage bony prominences. When you turn the patients, use pillows and wedges between their prominences, between their buttocks, their legs, their ankles, their elbows. Use pillows to support these patients. Do not use razors on patients who are at risk for bleeding. These patients may be on aspirin, Plavix, or heparin. If a doctor orders sitz baths for your patients, a sitz bath is done 20 to 30 minutes. Sitz baths are ordered for women after childbirth, patients who have had hemorrhoid surgery, hemorrhoidectomy, patients who have had incision and drainage of abscesses. Patients with impaired skin integrity, nurses should order a specialized bed for these patients. Patients who have a lot of decubitus ulcers, patients who are bariatric patients, obese patients, these patients need specialized beds. When you're giving a bed bath to a male patient, the perineal care, you should retract the skin of uncircumcised male when giving bed bath. When you're giving bed bath to a female patient, when you're cleaning the perineal area, wash from front to back. Patients with Foley catheters, make sure you're cleaning the insertion sites with gentle, mild soap and water. Male or female patients with Foley catheters, one of the major causes of impaired skin integrity in the hospitals are medical equipment. Patients who come in the hospital from the nursing home, they are admitted with G-tube. G-tube is used for tube feeding your patients. Make sure you wash the insertion sites with soap and water. Patients may have NG tube post-op after surgery, or patients may have NG tube if there is no G-tube. They may use the NG tube to feed these patients. Make sure your insertion sites are washed clean with soap and water. Some patients may have parenteral nutrition. Patients with impaired nutrition, they are at risk for impaired skin integrity. Doctors may order patients, some of the elderly's they are not able to swallow. So we have to tube feed them, or if they need parenteral nutrition for any reason, malnutrition, the doctor will order central line for these patients. But make sure central line is parenteral nutrition is ordered through these central lines IV. Make sure your IV sites, Heplog IVs, they are all kept clean with soap and water. Make sure you change the dressing on your IV sites. Medical equipment is one of the greatest source of infection in patients. In the hospital, patients are at risk for nasochromal infection. So we encourage people to wash their hands as much as possible. Nurses should wear short fingernails in the hospitals. Do not use artificial nails. Do not clip the nails of diabetic patients. Diabetic patients should be referred to a podiatrist for their fingernails and their toenails. You should know the word, the definition of sharing force. Sharing force wound ulcers occurs when the skin tissue layers causes subcutaneous blood vessels too stretched, resulting in disruption of the blood flow to the skin. You should know sharing force. One example of sharing force, patients with impaired skin integrity, we usually order a specialized bed for these patients, but the head of the bed should be 30 degrees. You can elevate the head of the bed 45, 90 degrees if you're feeding them or you're administering mouth care to these patients. But the preferred height of the bed should be 30 degrees. Back to sharing force. If the head of the bed is too high, the mattress is made out of plastic, we have to keep pulling them up in bed. Because the mattress is made out of plastic, these patients keep sliding down in bed, and we have to keep on pulling them up in bed, and there is sharing on the skin, causing skin breakdown. This is sharing force. Know this for your exam. Patients who are on contact isolation, Mercer, shingles, chicken pox, these patients go in a private room. Contact isolation, you gown, you gloves, gloves before, during procedure, and after procedure. Strict hand washing for these patients. We're talking about Mercer. Sometimes the doctors will ask us to swab the wound to see what kind of bacteria is present in the wound. We should send it to the lab, and sometimes the result comes back that these patients have Mercer and they are placed on contact isolation. Sometimes doctors order lotions and creams, ointments. If they are prescribed, they should be applied only by the registered nurse and the LPN. Prescriptions, patient care technicians do not apply creams, lotions, or ointments that are prescribed. Patient care technicians, they only apply barrier creams to patients or lotions or creams that are not prescribed by the doctor. When patient comes up from the emergency room, all nurses on admission complete the skin sheet on the skin sheet. If your patient's skin is intact, do not leave the sheet blank. Just write or check off skin is intact. Patients may be coming from a long-term care facilities with a lot of decubitus ulcers, 10, 12. Some of them are coming from home. I have a second nurse check off each ulcer that's on this patient. The nurses are responsible. Both nurses will sign this skin sheet. On the day of admission, the second day, any additional ulcers, as if you checked off 10 on admission day, and the second day, a nurse checked all those 10 ulcers and discovered that you did not check number 11, the hospital will be responsible for any ulcers that occur while the patients are in the hospital. If the patient's skin is intact on admission day, the second day the nurse discover the patient has one ulcer, the hospital will be responsible. The insurance companies do not pay for any pressure ulcers that occurs while the patients are in the hospital. Patients, when they're coming up from the emergency room with the decubitus ulcers, please order nutrition consultation for these patients. Patients with poor nutrition, if they were receiving tube feeding in the long-term care facilities, the doctors will give us an order to continue tube feeding them. Some patients may need parenteral nutrition. Patients with wounds coming into the hospital, or if a patient's skin was intact on admission day and you discover there are wounds second day, third day, all wounds, we have to do wound care consultation, ostomy nurse consultation. The wound care nurse is a registered nurse. Only registered nurses stages wounds, not doctors. It's the nurse's responsibilities. Patients with decubitus ulcers, the doctors will give us orders how to take care, how to dress these wounds, and will order medic creams are for these patients. When patients are admitted, we will document, starting the second day, every patient in the hospital. Every day, we document the NDNQI sheet. It's a pressure ulcer sheet. I told you the hospital is responsible for every pressure ulcers that occurs in the hospital. So every day, every nurse checks every patient 100% and document any pressure ulcers that occur in the hospital. The NDNQI sheet measures and aims to improve healthcare, safety, quality, integrity. The hospital is responsible for all pressure ulcers. We will pay, not the insurance companies. And I'm reminding you, we do not use harsh soaps on these patients. We do not. Okay, I will stop there for now and I'll continue in my next videos. Impaired skin integrity, it's a lot of information and I do not want to overwhelm you. So I'll be seeing you in my next video behind. And just hit the like button, thumbs up, hit your subscribe button and share my video and comment below. Stay blessed, take care, love you all. Be good.